Hi, this is Greg Olson with TSI. I'm TSI's industrial hygienist and the global product manager for the health and safety line of instruments. Today we're going to be going through a DustTrack setup and basically doing a quick rundown on identifying the components, setting up a DustTrack, and turning it on. Quick rundown, we're going to identify the components first. You've got the on-off button here on the front of the instrument. You have the aerosol inlet right over here. The color touchscreen obviously is down here in the front, and the power port is off to the left side, covered up. We have some other covers for the communications ports. You've got an analog output, a USB device host, and Ethernet communications. On the back side of the instrument, you've got a battery and battery cover door, and then you also have a filter cover door. Inside the filter cover door, you've got a 37 millimeter filter cassette that has an 80 micron sieve filter. This is not a gravimetric sampling setup, just so everybody knows. And then also over here is the HEPA sheath air filter, and that's removed by a spinner tool. The battery compartment will house two batteries. Each DustTrack comes with one battery, but if you'd like a second battery to extend sampling run times, you can certainly purchase another one as an accessory. Moving back around to other components that come in with a DustTrack, you also get a zero filter. You get an analog and alarm output cable. You get spare HEPA sheath filters. You get a spare inlet cover. You also get three different impactors, an impactor oil kit, PM10, PM4, PM2.5, and PM1. Impactors, you get two additional 37 millimeter 80 micron sieve filters, a USB cable, 3 feet or 1 meter of tubing, and it is not recommended to go with longer lengths of tubing than 3 feet or 1 meter because you're going to have aerosol losses if you do. You get a Dore Oliver Cyclone, a small little tool to go and pull the 37 millimeter filter cassettes apart with, and then last but not least, your spinner tool. Now, also on the back side of the instrument, you have an auto zero port. Now there's an auto zero module that fits on top of the DustTrack, which then plugs in here, and that's where it gets its commands to turn on and off so that you can auto zero during long periods of sampling. You'll notice right next to that, you have a bracket, and that's what houses or holds the Dore Oliver Cyclone captive so that you can do respirable work area monitoring. Okay? Now, what we're going to do is set up and install a battery. So we've already got a battery in here. All right? If you're going to charge a battery, what you need to do is utilize a power supply. We have 90 volt to 240 volt switching power supplies that are included with all DustTracks. So you can plug this into the wall on mains power, and as long as the instrument is turned on but it is not sampling, you will charge the battery. You cannot charge batteries and sample simultaneously. Now if you want to, you can run off of mains power, okay, without utilizing a battery in the instrument. Okay, that is not a problem. A lot of people will do that for long-term sampling applications where even two batteries inside a DustTrack 2 or a DRX will give you a long run time, but it won't give you enough to get through your sampling program. So now what you want to do basically after you get the instrument turned on is just hit the green start button, and the instrument will start in a survey mode. You're not taking any data. Now your DustTrack 2 or your DRX is up and running, and it's ready to provide you with data with real-time solutions. We'll see you again with more product training videos from TSI.